हेलो एवरीवन, ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग कॉन्सेप्ट्स इन सी प्लस प्लस। दिस कोर्स बिलोंग टू दोज हु नो लिटिल बिट अबाउट सी प्लस प्लस, दोज हु हैज लिटिल एक्सपीरियंस्ड अबाउट सी प्लस प्लस बट स्टिल कन्फ्यूज्ड अबाउट ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग कॉन्सेप्ट्स। दिस कोर्स इज नॉट अबाउट सी प्लस प्लस, दिस कोर्स इज अबाउट ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग कॉन्सेप्ट्स एंड लैंग्वेज यूज्ड is C++. So we are not going to cover different programming aspects of C++. We will just cover how we are proceed towards object-oriented programming from procedural programming. Okay? General concepts of object-oriented programming. I must think you already learned these words. You must have learned these words: data abstraction, data hiding, data encapsulation, inheritance, polymorphism, taplet, container shape, exception handling, reflection. These words you may be learned in first or second chapter of your textbook. Many books only include general concepts as data abstraction, data hiding, data encapsulation, inheritance and polymorphism. And they do not include template, container shape, exception handling, reflection in their first chapter. But believe me, all these concepts are only belongs to object-oriented programming. In this series, we will discuss just a first four of these concepts, not all. Because goal of this course is to clear you somewhat about object-oriented programming in practical way. While talking about practical way, what I mean, when I started to learning C++, initially I learned in my chapter first or chapter second about this data abstraction. They have written there is a car which has machinery inside, and you have given with a steering, and you have given it a brake, a clutch, a gear. So hiding the machinery, they told, is a data hiding. Showing the steering, brake or gear is data abstraction. And contain many things inside a car together is data encapsulation. This thing they used to say means showing the useful thing after hiding the useless things, not useless, after hiding the thing you are not going to use. Hiding machinery and showing brakes. Okay, showing actual thing is called data abstraction, and hiding the background things, not useful. Hiding the background things are data hiding. But okay, in the terms of car, I understand. Okay, machinery is inside, that is data hiding. We are showing the what we need to drive the car, like brake, gear, clutch, etc. That is data abstraction. But while learning these things as a car, it is not clear to me where in the programming we are going to use this. And I think this is the biggest problem of newcomers in object oriented programming. They started with first chapter and do not understand anything what is happening, because they given an example of a car and they do not come to understand what about programming. Okay, in car you are hiding, you are showing. But what about programming? In programming, where are you hiding? Where are you showing? In this course, we will show you everything as programmatically, as a programming style. We start with procedural style, gradually move to object-oriented style. And we are going to use same problem. For same problem, first we will create a program in which is little bit more ugly, not object oriented. then we will improve that program slowly towards object orientation. You will see the difference while moving towards object orientation. And you can also see live and practical example of some of the object oriented programming concepts. Some of them means we are going to discuss only four, not all, because this course is not about all. This course is useful for those beginners who are confused about what is object oriented programming actually. Why we are using C++? C++ is only language which support both procedural and object oriented programming style. Java is a pure object oriented programming language. So when a person start programming with Java, he knows only object oriented programming. He did not even seen how procedural programming looks. Okay, if someone start with just object oriented programming and didn't even seen what is procedural programming, then they cannot differentiate. So C++ is only a programming language which support both procedural and object oriented programming style. That's why to explain the object oriented concepts, we started with C++. Of course, this is not a complete course of C++, but you will understand some of the object oriented programming concepts. Talking about platform, I am going to use VI editor on Ubuntu and G++ compiler on Ubuntu. It doesn't mean you must have to use Ubuntu, because I know many one who belong to first year or second year going to use this video. So you use whatever you are using. Maybe you are using Dev C++ on Windows. Maybe you are using code blocks on the Windows. You can use whatever you are using. Don't see how I am editing or compiling. You do your editing and compiling as you want. Okay. So best of luck for the course. Bye.